Yeah, so I will share my screen because there will also be a demo. So you can just see my screen probably in the presentation. Good. So, good evening, everybody. My name is Jörg Thaim, and today I'm going to present you a pet project of mine called Inspector. And this is a drop anywhere C++ REPL. So a bit about my person. I'm currently doing a PhD in systems research in the lovely city Edinburgh in Scotland. And as projects, I'm working currently on Centre, which is a container debugging tool. And upcoming project is a time travel debugging tool. But this talk is going to be about Inspector. But let's first start what REPL is. This is some kind of interactive programming environment. So this means that it consists of the following steps. It first reads some code from the user. It then evaluates that depending on the programming language and prints the result type. And this is in a loop, so it will repeat after that. And there are several examples for different programming languages. For instance, IPython has such a tool for Python, and there's also MATLAB, and yeah, the godfather of all REPLs was implemented in Lisp. So what's the difference between a REPL and a drop anywhere REPL, which I have built? A drop anywhere REPL is something which works like a breakpoint. So you can insert that in a program, and it will work in running programs, and you can interact with the program state and access local variables and so on. So there are different drop anywhere REPLs already existing for subdynamic programming languages. Like in Python, you have PDB, which comes in the standard library. For Ruby, there's this great REPL called Pry. You can insert into your running program. And now what I've built for C++ is Inspector, which I'm going to show you now. So let's take that C++ program here. And you will see that difference here is this include statement. And what this include statement does is when you execute the program, it will stop at this line, and it then will open in a different window, a REPL, where you can interact with the running program. So I'm going to show you now a quick demo how that works. So I switch now. So the first step one needs to do is running some pre-compilation step on this example program. So this is the same program I just showed in the slides. As the console font, that's better. Okay. So at first, that's a pre-built step which generates some code. Then you can use any C++ compiler, and currently it works the way that you inject some command line flags. So now we have the program. The next thing we need to do is starting the REPL and then running our program. What we see here now is the program has started, and it pracked at the first inspector line. So now we are inside this REPL, and we can execute any code we want. So we can, you see that variables are accessible. You can call member functions. You can mutate memory. And you can also do things like function calls. And because it's a REPL, you can also define new functions. It supports C++ 17, so you can use any feature you want, and you can also do things like defining class and do instantiations of that. Yeah, so it's fully functional. And yeah, you can life changing also the memory. So if you continue that now and you give it a new value here, then it would also have a value here. And yeah, you can have multiple of these breakpoints, and you can also have conditional ones if you put them in an if clause or so. Yeah, so that's basically how Center works, how Inspector works. And yeah, now I'm going to explain to you what it does under the hood, because actually not that much magic. And I built this tool in a 3-day hackathon. And yeah, it's based on some existing work. So there was a tool called Clean, which already implement this REPL part. And what I did is make it a library, so you can inject this into your programs, as you have seen in the demo. So what's the difference between this REPL and yeah, common debuggers? You can use Inspector with default optimization flags, so you don't need something like debug symbols, or you don't need to run it without optimization flags, because only this code which only the line where you inject this REPL will be made sure that there's no optimization. So you can access all the variables because I forced the compiler to not optimize the variables in this small code piece where Inspector is executed. And yeah, it also has in contrast to debuggers, has full programming language support, so it can execute any C++ code. And it's not just yeah, poking in memory, so yeah, it's a real programming language. You can do everything, and you can also do that with multiple processes. So to now break down what yeah, steps Inspector do to run your program. So the first thing you have seen is this generation step. So you give Inspector all the files where you have inserted this include statement. And what it will do is it will take libclang and scan the source code for this include statement, and then it will generate for each time you include Inspector, it will generate a function call. And in this function call, it will generate a code similar to what you see here in the presentation. So it will take references of, or not the addresses of all variables in the scope, so all local variables and all global variables, so you have them accessible in the REPL, and it will also include the code, so the REPL can work with that. Then the next step is what Inspector do is, if you compile your program, it will give you some C flags you have to include. So these C flags will include something like an macro. So you have seen this include inspector will expand to a macro which is unique per line and per file. And for each of these yeah, file and line numbers, I will generate a header in the background. And what it also does is it includes a dynamic library which is injected into the running program. So the last step is yeah, actually running a program. So before the program is started, you have to also have to start Inspector itself. It will open a local server listening on TCP, and then when you run the program and it hits this line where this Inspector was included, it will make a connection to that. And then it will exchange some messages back and forth, so you can have your debug session. And this design has the advantage that you can also do things like remote debugging, and you can also have multiple processes or multiple threads, and they will get yeah, connected to your REPL in serial. So you will wait until they are yeah, until their turn is. Yeah, so yeah, I built this tool on the hackathon, as I thought, so it's working for me. And yeah, so some problems which yeah, has to be solved. So Packaging still takes still some efforts because you need to compile LLVM in CLang, or in other words, you have to compile a fork of them where Kling is implemented. There's also no build system or IDE integration at the moment, so you have to invoke for every source file you have included that REPL manually. And yeah, I have also lots of projects, so I would be glad if I can get some more contributors or co-maintainers to make the project more useful. Yeah, and I would be also happy to give other presentations on other locations or so to make the concept more well known. So yeah, that was everything about Inspector. The source code is here on this project URL. There's also a build description there, and yeah, so that would be all from my side. And yeah, maybe you can take now some questions.
Yeah, thanks. Any questions?
You cannot go up at the moment, yes. So that would be in theory, it would be possible. Yeah, I also thought about integrating this into actual debuggers, but then I'm limited to what the debugger can provide me as information, so it might not give me access to all variables. But you're limited to your scope, but for that reason, you can insert multiple REPLs in multiple lines and get multiple scopes. But you can access all variables, all local and all global variables in the same file. Yeah. the project when I was working on when was working on was Klee, which is a symbolic execution engine, and I used that for that. But yeah, at the moment, I'm actually not using that much C++, to be honest. So, but yeah, maybe later again. Yeah, but yeah, I use REPLs in all other programming languages where they are also available quite often, because it's it's quite cool to have this quick feedback where you can just enter a line of code and see how the API behaves, because that's not often not clear from the documentation or so. So there, I find it very useful.